think that there needs to be a very clear definition of what physical and psychological dependence are. Along the way, you need people making those distinctions and making the distinction that patients chronically taking opioids will become physically dependent, but that's not psychological dependence or addiction. And that when patients with cancer who are taking opioids withdraw from their medications, that doesn't mean that they're addicts. That means that they're in withdrawal because they're physically dependent.
What we're talking about with dependence is really two factors. One is physiological, where the body says we actually have to have this medicine on board. Addiction and the psychological dependence that we talk about is when people start craving these drugs and continue to use them despite documented harm.
What usually happens to somebody taking opioids for pain relief is that they get physical dependence. So that if you stop it all of a sudden, they may get a little restless in the beginning, they may get agitated, they may get diarrhea, they may get abdominal cramps, but that is not addiction.
One particular patient that we treated had very significant pain, was on large doses of opioids, and we performed a procedure called a chordotomy, which is a surgical procedure to interrupt the pain pathways coming from the brain to the spine and to the lower extremities. And following the procedure, their pain completely disappeared. And we said to the patient, well, we need to keep you on your pain medicine because we don't want you to withdraw. And she said, well, why would I take those drugs? I don't have any pain. So for the more than the majority, I'd say for 95% of patients taking these medications, this is not about the use of these medicines for anything other than pain relief.
The experience if you are a healthy person and you take morphine is very different, I think, as the experience of a patient who gets morphine. It seems that pain is modifying in a way the chemistry and the way that we really react to opioids.
The research has shown that it's like a very infinitesimal percentage of cancer patients that become addicted. And you know, it's just a ridiculous argument. You know, if a cancer patient with stage 3 or 4 stage cancer, you know, is suffering with pain, it's ridiculous to think that, you know, they're going to become addicted to the drug.
I'm getting very upset when I hear people, you know, oh, you give them a little bit morphine to feel more euphoric. I mean, yeah, I never saw a cancer patient getting morphine becoming euphoric. I mean, they get a pain relief, they get a good sleep.
Of the thousands of patients I've seen, it does not change someone. If it works to control their pain, they're happy, they're symptom-free, they're also adverse effect-free. If it doesn't work for their pain, they stop taking it. If their pain gets better, they stop taking it. It does not have this magical power to change someone.
There's a difference between being physically dependent and being addicted. And I'll often use an analogy of another medication that we prescribe. It's called a beta blocker. It's a medicine that we use for high blood pressure. And it turns out when you're on a beta blocker, if you were to stop it cold turkey, you would go into withdrawal from that beta blocker. And your blood pressure would go sky high and you could have other side effects. Many people will say if you could go into withdrawal, then you must be addicted. But that's actually not the case. That's the case of being physically dependent. Addiction is much more psychological dependence. You crave and you need the substance. I always tell patients, I don't think you've ever seen people on the street corner prostituting themselves to get a beta blocker for blood pressure. So just because you can get physically dependent on a medicine does not mean you're addicted to it. So everybody who's on an opioid for any period of time will become physically dependent, and I tell people that. You can't stop it, you have to taper it off, but that has nothing to do with psychological dependence or addiction.